Self-righteousness refers to our general tendency to give ourselves the benefit of the doubt, combined with our extraordinary ability as reasoning creatures to employ reason only to reach the conclusions we want to reach. That's the general rule about reasoning. Thinking is for doing. We employ our reasoning to reach the conclusions we want to reach. So if we're mad at someone, we very easily find reasons why they're wrong and we're right. So this is just part of the nature of who we are. I think this helps us understand a lot about our current political situation, about the nastiness of our political divides, and why it is that it's just so hard for us to see that there is wisdom on both sides of almost any longstanding question. This is the most important lesson I learned in writing the happiness hypothesis, is that if you're a liberal, you're not going to learn much by reading more liberal writing. Pick up some conservative magazines, pick up some conservative thinkers. It's revelation after revelation. There are a lot of good ideas over there. And of course, vice versa. But my point is, we only seek out conclusion. We only seek out evidence that supports the conclusion we want to reach, and therefore, we deprive ourselves of most of the interesting ideas in the world. Conservatives, I believe, are much, much wiser about the limitations of the individual, about the flaws of reasoning, and about the need to anchor us in a past. Liberals tend to be very high on openness to experience. Liberals love change, love diversity. The very fact that something is an old idea is a reason to doubt it. It probably comes from a time of patriarchy. It's outdated. I've recently discovered that the metaphor of a wall is a great acid test for separating liberals from conservatives. If you tell liberals there is a wall over there, they'll say, oh, well, let's knock it down. Walls are bad. We need to knock down walls. We need to all move around, and we need free flow and, you know, no obstacles. And conservatives are much wiser about the need for structure, the need for limitations. If everything is possible, it's very hard for people to find satisfaction. This was the great insight of the sociologist Emile Durkheim, another liberal who basically, when you read him today, sounds like he's onto some great conservative ideas. So I think liberals desperately need to read some conservative theory to understand that a world of freedom, mobility, and diversity is a recipe for a world of chaos, anomie, and social dissolution.